Happy Friday. Welcome to the Parsley Woods. I'm Duke of the Bump. I'm getting a real Forest of Illusion vibe from this place. With the trees, with the creepy jack-o'-lantern faces. Like the Forest of Illusion from, Super Mario World. I almost forgot the name of Super Mario World. How foolish of me. Also, it looks like we have an actual minecart coming up. Not like that fake, unlicensed minecart from a couple levels ago. Oh, yeah, it's this music again. I like this music pretty well. Not my favorite in the world, but nice and creepy sounding. Huh. This looks like, should be part of the foreground, not the background, but apparently not. I wonder if I can stick my horns into stuff underwater. I guess not. Does not seem to be working. Hey! Well, that was pretty rude. Hey, it's a ghost spear guy. Do they work? I guess they work like the booze, because when I'm looking at him, he doesn't get shy, he just kind of phases out of existence. So not exactly like a boo, but analogous. Aw, man, how do I get that? Oh wait, that's right. Oh, I guess you can't kill the ghost spirit guys. I thought this was part of the foreground again. Hey! It's awfully dark to be part of the background. Oh, not only can you kill the ghosts, you can pick them up as well. Interesting. Very unusual ghost physics. Then again, maybe it's not a ghost. Maybe it's just a specter or a phantom. Or one of those, dang it, millions of undead creatures that I fought in Dungeon Hack. Aw, man. Seriously, I hope that game had enough of undead stuff. Not sure why this area is called the Parsley Woods. I mean, it seems to have kind of like a spooky Halloween motif going on with the, dang it, with the jack-o'-lantern trees and the ghosts and the creepy music, but I don't know, parsley doesn't strike me as the spookiest of the herbs. It's one of the tastiest, I'll grant you that. Parsley, it's pretty good. I mean, it's no garlic, obviously, but it'll do in a pinch. Mix it with some sage, rosemary, and thyme. You have yourself, what? Wow. You cannot go very far down into the sea floor. Like, if this was a Mario game, you could probably fully submerge yourself, and you would still have a little leeway. But in this, as soon as your foot touches the seabed, you're done for. I was going to say, combine parsley with some sage, rosemary, and thyme, and you have 4 of the kernel's 7 secret herbs and spices. The other 3? Salt, grease, and MSG. Finger looking good. What? How did the spiky ball die? That was weird. Oh, I guess it just reached the end of its journey. The end of its natural life. Aw, man. I didn't know where to go. Oh, I guess they die when they bump into things. Just like all the other enemies. Well, they die if you bump into them. Or bump them into a wall while they're incapacitated. Music is a little repetitive, I guess. 40 coins? Sure. That seems like a good investment. good investment in Wario's future. I am down to 12 lives after all. Which is the less unlucky of the two numbers. It's not as unlucky as 13, of course, because nothing's as unlucky as 13. But it's not as lucky as 14. It's close, but not quite there yet. Bunny hat, bunny hat, bunny hat. Hey. So the spiky balls appear to come out sort of on a bullet bill schedule. If I'm under where the spike ball comes out, then it pauses. But if I'm not underneath that, then maybe once I'm past it, it deactivates. I thought maybe that spiky ball would fall on this little hole. There has to be something down here, right? Maybe not. It sure looks like all of the other parts of the seabed that immediately kill me. This wasn't a secret level. Or this wasn't... This didn't have a secret exit, did it? I forget. I'll have to check the map. Well, let's see. I think I'll hold on to my coins. Stay with my 12 lives. I don't need to try for any more at the moment. No, there's no bullseye there, so no secret exit. Okay. No point in going back there. Unless there was a treasure, which I missed. Which is quite possible. Aw, man. More minecarts. Or more fake minecarts. I was hoping for a real minecart. Real minecarts for my sham friends. Sham minecarts for my real friends. That's a pretty dumb motto. If that's your motto, then maybe you should rethink your life. Better music. Still pretty sinister sounding. I'd say I'm a little disappointed that I'm still fighting those birds. I mean, Mario Land 2 seemed to have a wide variety of new enemies, new enemy types in every area, but in this game, it's like 99% the spiky dudes, or the spear dudes, and the birds. Okay, maybe that's a little bit of an exaggeration, but it still seems pretty high. Music's almost like a march. Like a grim death march, if you will. Speaking of grim death, somebody had an obsession when they were decorating this place. Jeez. I probably shouldn't have let that fake minecart get away from me. Because, oh, I guess it does respawn. I checked in a previous level to see if they respawn, and it didn't look like they did, but I guess I just didn't get far enough away from the spawning point. Hey. Man. The problem with the Game Boy is that with such a limited color palette, sometimes what's in the background and what's in the foreground can be a little confusing. Like, I thought this was going to be part of the background. I don't know why. It's just, it was a particular shade of gray that made me think that way. Oh, good, a response here. I was worried that I'd have to go all the way back. Aw, man. Man, you have to be fast. I wish I had my bunny hat. Aw, hearts. I was hoping for a power-up. Oh well. Oh yeah, it's the mines. Don't mind if I do. Oh. I guess that was the end. Oh yeah, it's like the teapot dome where you hit that and something about the level changes. So I guess I just drained that lake. That's cool, I guess. I mean, it seems a little bad for the environment. All right, I'm down to 11 lives, so I better spend some coin. Better be worth a B course. I better get better than a B on this. Better get an A. Oh, come on! I was one bar away from the absolute peak. Should have been a little bit faster than that. I guess it is the ducks, though. They're a faster enemy than I'm used to. Hey, no prob. I don't know why this music made me think of a 50s. Oh, come on! How did that explosion not kill that duck? The Fonz is not happy about this. Alright, well, 3 out of 5 on the B course. That's pretty good. It's enough for a 1-up, I guess. It would have been pretty cool to get 2-up or 3-up. Oh well, at least I'm back at the semi-lucky number now. Alright, so I guess I need to head up to that lake. Whoa! Was parsley always spelled like that? That's not right. It should be P-A-R-S-L-E-Y. Huh. I don't think it was like that before. That's weird. Oh hey! Music's nice and jaunty. Not quite what I was expecting from all the skulls lying around. This is much more traditional Mario sounding music. I like it. Not sure why this level gets the jaunty music, since there seems to be an abundance of skulls. Something's shaking the whole area. Wait, am I in a train or something? Is that what this is? If so, they probably shouldn't have. Oh, I can't get back. I was going to leave and see if I was on a train. I mean, the whole room is kind of yeah, it's a train. Oh, okay. So I guess that's what that quote unquote minecart was. It was actually a train. And it's an auto scroll level. First one we've had in any Mario Land game, I think. Oh wait. Oh crap. Oh, okay. Yeah, I don't remember there being an auto-scrolling level in any Mario Land game up to this point. Having the jetpack is definitely going to be a boon here. Okay. Hey! No! No scimitar! That's close. More like scimitarnt. See what I did there? Total burn on that duck. Dragon hat or rabbit hat? I think I'll stick with my rabbit hat, actually. I mean, I do like the dragon hat, but, especially on these auto-scroll levels, I think having the ability to fly a little bit is more important than being able to breathe fire. Man, I bet there's good stuff in those boxes. Probably laid the key to a treasure or something, and I just wasn't fast enough. Now see, that's why you would want the dragon act here. Hey! I hate these birds. They've had more BS deaths and hits from these birds than anything else in this game. Well, good. I wanted to get that dragon hat and get those boxes anyway. Shows you, bird. I actually wanted to die there. So ha. Wait, this game just brings out the mature adult in me, doesn't it? All right, box him. You're mine. Okay, a heart. That's not, not totally amazing, but... Oh, my coin. That's, uh-oh. I'm in trouble. Okay. Well, bummer. At least now it's easier for me to deal with those birds. Always check where you don't think the game wants you to go. Because 9 times out of 10, there's not going to be anything there. But 1 time out of 10, there's probably going to be a secret there. And you know, I like those odds. I don't have to pay to leave the level. That's cool, I guess. Alright, 12 lives. I'm good. Just want to hold on to my hoard. Hold on to my stash. Not my mustache. I always hold on to that. Hold on to my coin stash. Okay, well, I guess that'll about do it for Parsley Woods, or Parsley Woods, part 1. Have a good weekend, everyone. Probably not going to be a stream this weekend. I don't know. It depends on how busy I am on Sunday. If there is, I'll post, as usual, I'll post a Twitter, Facebook, YouTube update about it so y'all know. And I'll post an update in the Steam group, so make sure you join the Steam group if you haven't already. I'm Duke of the Bump. See y'all Monday.